Hello everyone. So in last class we was learning these note points. Okay, let's continue that part in today's class, which is very small. Let's finish it. So we have seen this note point number one. What is this note point number one? The gas equation in terms of density D, right? The gas, no need to write these two points. The gas equation in terms of density, that is D. Then we wrote like this, P dT is equal to constant, and therefore P1 by D1 T1 is equal to P2 by D2 T2 is equal to constant. And we know what is that from how you got P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2 is always constant. Therefore, we are getting this formula, okay, in terms of density. Next note point, we have learned like this. When pressure and volume are constant, when pressure and volume are constant, then we have this PV is equal to small m by capital M into R, and that implies M is inverse proportional to temperature, that is equal to M is equal to K by T, where K is constant, and therefore M1 by M2 is equal to T2 by T1, which is also one formula in terms of mass and temperature when pressure and volume is constant. And this is what the form of ideal gas equation. You know this. So already we have learned this. Okay. So next, from here you have to note down. Third point, if the gas with physical parameters, P1, V1, T1 is mixed. Is mixed with another gas. Oh, physical parameter P2, V2, T2. Then, if resultant mixture has parameters P, V, T, then we know P1, V1 by T1 plus P2, V2 by T2 is equal to PV by T. It's our problem. What we are doing? Just addition of that two, isn't it? So we are adding that two, and then what we are doing? Resultant we are taking, isn't it? So we have taken that resultant. Okay. Clear? Next. Next note point. Note down this. Next note point is note point number 4. Already we have learned this, still one more time. An air bubble rises from bottom of a lake to the top. Rises from bottom of lake to top. If V1 and V2 are the volumes of air bubble, if V1 and V2 are volumes of air bubble and T1 and T2 are temperatures, V2 are temperatures at bottom and top, at bottom and top, then how to use formula and which formula I should use. Listen here, I am drawing one small diagram. This is a bottom of the lake, we can say. Here it is volume V1, comma temperature is T1, and you are having pressure also. Let us suppose here how much pressure is P1, isn't it? Now this bubble, when it is coming at top, you know its volume is rising. So this is V2, temperature T2, and pressure is P2. And what is this height is H. So use this law. What is that? P1 V1 by T1 is equal to what? P2 V2 by T2. P1 means what? Pressure at bottom. Pressure at bottom is what? Pressure at bottom is equal to pressure at top plus H rho G. So we know this already, we have learned. So can I write right here like this direct now? H plus H rho G into P1 divided by T1 is equal to, here it is at the top, so just H rho G into P2 divided by T2. And now this rho G and this rho G will get cancelled. And I am getting formula like this, H plus H into V1 divided by T1 is equal to H into V2 divided by T2, where H is what? Pressure in centimeter. Yes or not? Capital H, you know, 76 centimeter of H, whatever they will give, and H is what? Height. Now here, you know, if I will write V1 is equal to 4 by 3 pi R1 cube, and V2 is equal to 4 by 3 pi R2 cube, and I will substitute here, then what is the formula in terms of R? This 4 by 3 pi R1 cube, this 4 by 3 pi will get cancelled here, and I am getting formula like this, H plus H into R1 cube divided by T1 is equal to H into R2 cube divided by T2. This formula, when you have to use, when they are giving radius of bubble, and this formula when you have to use when they have given volume and temperature of that bubble at the point where at bottom and at the top, we can see. Understood? Very easy. Already we have learned this in Boyle's law only. Note down fast. Okay, next. Let's move ahead now. Next one. At the top of mountain, a thermometer reads, next note point. Next is fourth or fifth, you check it, fifth one. Okay. So this note point is note point number 5. At the top of mountain, a thermometer reads, at the top of mountain thermometer reads even Kelvin temperature and barometer reads H1 centimeter. Of Hg pressure, centimeter of Hg pressure at the bottom of mountain. At the bottom of mountain, they read T2 Kelvin and H2 centimeter. Of Hg respectively. If D1 and D2 are densities of air, if D1 and D2 are densities of air at the top and bottom of mountain, top and bottom of mountain, then we know formula. Already we have learned density in terms of density formula. P1 by D1 T1 is equal to P2 by D2 T2. P1 is what? That implies you can see here H1 centimeter. You know? So pressure is what? H1 divided by D1 T1 is equal to H2 divided by D2 into D2. If you want D1 and D2 here from this, you can make your own formula for density. So you just transfer there, you are getting D1 by D2 is equal to H1 T2 divided by H2 T1. This is what density. You can find out. They will ask in problem. They will give you these values, and from this, they will ask you to find anything. So you have to use this formula. So keep it in mind. When you are getting problem on ideal gas equation, which formula you have to use in terms of density or in terms of volume, that you should know. That you will get idea from given things. Okay. So for that, you need to practice numericals. I will give you that later. After class, I will send some photos. Okay. So note down this. Okay, next. Expression of density for different gases. This is the last topic of this gases part. Then we will start transmission of heat and then calorimetry. This is the biggest chapter, okay? So keep it in mind. Next is what? Transmission, and then after that, calorimetry. Then it will finish. Okay. So let's see the next topic, that is expression of density for different cases. Expression of density for different cases. The first, already we know rho is equal to what? Mass by volume. So from ideal gas equation, PV is equal to RT. So V is equal to what here? M by rho, enough? M by rho. So therefore, can I write like this? Rho is equal to P M by RT. Pm by RT. Okay. यहाँ पे if suppose for n number of moles you want, can we do like this? 1 minute. Here, if I am doing like this, PV is equal to n RT, and this V, that implies I am writing like this. V is equal to m by rho. M by rho. So I will add here in this equation. So P into this V is what? M by rho. And we know this number of moles is what? Small m by capital M. Isn't it? Into R into T. So this M and this M will get cancelled. And if you want density, so I'm taking reciprocal, or else wait, I will do one more step. So from this, I am getting like this. P by rho is equal to RT by capital M. And keep in mind, this small m is mass and this is molecular weight. Keep it in mind always. Number of moles means small m by capital M. This m is mass, this is molecular weight. Now I want density from this. If I want density, I am taking reciprocal. So what you are getting? Rho by P is equal to m by RT, and therefore rho is equal to P into m divided by RT. This is what density formula we are getting. Clear? Now from this, you can conclude, see here, I can write like this, P is directly proportional to rho, okay? So therefore, this rho T graph, okay, rho T graph, and then rho V graph also we will plot. So wait, that will I plot in the next page. First you understood this still here, rho is equal to Pm by RT, which is what our density is. Clear? Note down. If you have doubt, call me. Okay. So next. Next one. Let's plot some graph. This is number one, this one is number two, and this one is number three. Okay. And this all graphs we have plotted from only one equation. That is what? Rho is equal to Pm by RT. Okay. Rho is equal to what? Pm by RT, as we know. So see here. If I will take here density rho, and here I will take pressure, okay, on y axis density, on x axis pressure, then you are getting graph something like this. Something like this, which is straight line. And here, what we have to assume constant, T constant, as well as M also constant. Agree, no? Yes or not? Rho is direct proportional to P. When it is possible? When temperature and M is constant, because R is already constant, isn't it? Got it? Next. If I am plotting density versus temperature graph, in this case, where pressure and mass is constant, then you are getting rectangular hyperbola. P is constant as well as M also constant. And next one, if we will plot rho versus V, rho and V, then this is also you are getting as a rectangular hyperbola. Here only M is constant. Got it? So these are the graphs from these equations we have plotted. So this is end of our gases part. So we have finished thermometry. Yes, thermal expansion, then expansion in solid, liquid and gases. Okay, thermometry means all temperature scales and related all models. Then thermal expansion, in that thermal expansion in solids, alpha, beta, gamma and all. Then thermal expansion in liquid and thermal expansion in gases. Till here, up to this point, the syllabus for exam will be there, up to this point. Understand? So I will send almost 20 questions which you have to solve immediately after listening this. Got it? Right? So this is what end of gases. And so we are going to stop here. So prepare well for exam, right? And solve maximum problems. This is only MCQ exam, okay? Only MCQ, multiple choice questions. Okay, bye.